You.
Hello?
Hello? Are you there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yay.
Yay.
You sound super enthused.
I'm already 2 bowls in, too.
Nice. Did you kick the dog a couple times before we started?
No.
You might want to go ahead and do that, get that out of the way.
I'll wait till later, when he's not fucking taking a piss right before bed. Like, God damn it, just do it!
See if we can get JC on a minute first. Man, I don't see how he doesn't get it at all, dude.
I know.
Like, how has that never occurred to him? That's a huge fucking inconvenience.
It's just he's saying, "You're gonna love it." No, I'm not.
Now it's worse because now you're actually stuck with it.
Yep.
Beaner. Oh, there you are.
Hey.
Hey guys, hang on a second. The cat gotta go outside. I gotta go walk the cat real quick. Yeah, I gotta walk the cat real quick. Oh, never mind, you don't have to fucking do that.
Dude, look, it's not the worst thing in the world and I will eventually get used to it.
But it's up there.
It sucks. But I will never love this animal. I know myself enough to know that I got no love for it. I'll coexist with it, but you know, I just can't wait till I get a cat.
Did we cover the whole Fans Toys Skyfire repaint in the news? I don't think we did.
No, I think we may have mentioned it because you talked about buying it.
No, it's like raising somebody else's kid you don't like.
Mm-hmm.
That's how the dog is. That's how dogs are. Because they're basically like a giant child.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing, Junior? Get out of there. My cat's crawling underneath my computer desk and he's on a transformer shelf trying to get under there.
He's trying to be relevant. He's like, I'm going to fuck something up, damn it.
Get
I'm
out
tired
of
all. All they talk about is these stupid fucking dogs. I'm going to go eat some shit. Chew on a cord.
Now he's down by my feet. Stays down there through the whole show. I'll be fine.
Nice. Is he going to bite your feet?
He might.
Nice.
Does he have free reign of the house with the dog?
There's no dog here.
Oh, I thought there was.
I used to have a dog.
Oh, okay.
He died a while ago.
Okay.
But, the right now living with my dad and sister, she's got 2 cats and I got 1 and... mine's the only male and the only one with the front claws. The other 2 are female and declawed.
Nice. So he rules the fucking house.
So he's kind of a bully, yeah. But at the same time, her 1 cat is... even though she doesn't have claws, she pushes him around and hisses at him and he runs away. But, and they only have access to about half the house because me and my dad jury-rigged a makeshift door that cuts off the living room and my dad's bedroom from the dining room / kitchen and our rooms.
The cat-free zone?
Yeah, well, back when there were dogs here, when my sister's dog was still alive as well, my sister's 1 cat had a issue where she liked to piss on the couch.
And yay!
Yeah, we found a cat that's bad, finally.
And I think a lot of that was because her dog would go in the litter box and chase the cat out of there.
Yeah, so, then that's their own fault. Yeah.
So we built the door so the cat couldn't get in there and piss on the furniture anymore. So. And then I moved out, and then I ended up back here. So.
It's home sweet home.
How's the house hunting going?
I've been keeping my eyes open. I haven't really looked at any closely yet other than the one. One I'm considering calling about.
Small Peter.
The only problem is that it's like only like five houses away from zone.
That's fine. You just like don't let her know you're moving there.
It's impossible.
It's not.
She'll see him.
Buy her a dog. She won't have time to fuck with you.
She will, in one swift motion, see him, realize that he lives there now, and take her kid over so he can babysit.
Fuck no.
Here, I'll post it in chat. So that's the one I'm interested in right now.
Nice.
Now, have you gone out and physically looked at any of them?
I went and looked at one, and it needed way too much work. This one doesn't look like it needs too much work off the bat, and then you slowly but surely upgrade it. You know, stick some money into it here and there in certain rooms, and but.
Get Tyler to come out and remodel it for you.
I mean, it's clear if you look at some of the rooms, like, it's got, like, some really old trim that looks like almost like original trim on the in some of the rooms, but it'd be something to start out with, at least. Mm-hmm. And it's only $64.9, and...
I can't believe there's houses that cost that much. You know what that buys you here? A used fucking car.
Well, and... I mean, that one that I was interested in Loyal before, that DA was saying I should buy, that's still on the market too, but again, that's one bedroom, even though it's been completely remodeled, so I'm worried about how hard it'll be to try to resell it, should I actually need to. And, yeah, it's $48,000 compared to, and a lot smaller compared to the other one that I just posted.
Let me get in there. Something's going on with my fucking messenger tonight.
No, mine was acting up earlier today. Like, it wouldn't put my messages through. It would fail. Mm. Like, it only has one fucking job. Put my fucking message on the screen.
Yes, it's in the fucking name.
Yeah, messenger.
So we're not going to discuss the Maketoys add-ons in the news?
I think we should, because I think they should be asshole of the week.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, let's do it there.
Because, I mean, like I said, Phil's not going to be on until, like, 8:10, so...
8:10 your time or my time?
My time.
Damn.
So...
Say my time.
So we'll have, like, a half hour before he even gets on. That's what I was looking at, what we could do to kind of fill that gap.
I can fill a gap. Yeah.
You know, we can throw in the Wajang Blue fucking Omega.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead and throw in the fucking wing thing, I guess an asshole week. Let's see, what else?
Where the fuck's JC? Is he still sleeping?
Probably. I thought he wasn't going to be on tonight, because he's got to work 24 hours.
He's being a bitch.
Did he ever say he wasn't going to come on then?
No.
I don't know, I thought he did.
I never seen him say he wasn't coming on.
No, who knows? Maybe he got busy fishing and jerking off. And crying. And voting Democrat.
Yeah, Fred's sad that somebody knocked off Toilet Bot now.
I'll buy a Toilet Bot, man. Hook me up.
Of course, this is a much better rendition. But who thought it would be a good idea to make it look like a fucking Japanese shogun?
So I got the repugnus.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I got that in, and I got the punch counter punch in. You know, just the you know, regular old, you know, Hasbro ones.
Yeah, I fucked up on that. I kept just waiting, and I was just gonna order it once it was released instead of
which one?
The punch counter punch, and it's fucking sold out right now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like it said, there was a delay in it coming out, and like it said, like, you know, your item has a whatever delay, but that motherfucker still showed up today when it was supposed to, so I don't know what's the deal.
I still haven't been charged for mine.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I love repugnus. I like repugnus just like I like blot. Like, what the fuck is it? Who knows?
I just checked my credit card, and yeah, I don't have a charge for it. And for my two fembots that I ordered, but no charge for counterpunch it.
Radio edit.
I still gotta get those fucking fembots. I haven't got those yet either. Well, I can't get Nova Star anymore. She's out of stock now, unless you want to pay a stupid price for her.
That's fine. That's why I'm glad I ordered her when I did.
You know, see, I'm not doing it, because what's going to happen is 6 months from now, they'll be the only fucking thing on the shelf. I'm not ordering it. I'm going to wait until it's at Walmart for the next year.
It's not going to be at Walmart. It's going to be at fucking Ollie's.
Yeah, whatever.
Because this is the last waves, and you know damn well that's where they're going to show up. I mean, people were finding the jump starters and Windblade there. So any of the fourth and fifth wave of the line is probably going to be at Ollie's.
I do wish I found the other Windblade. I don't have the second one. I never got that guy, that one.
The Headmaster? Yeah, I'd like to get that one.
I still think the original one looks better, because the original one's like way more like detailed, but
it's tippy.
I don't know. The new one is like more accurate later on in the comic. They slowly changed her design during the run of that comic.
I should go back and get the Monster Bots, though. I didn't get the exclusive or the retail release one.
Oh, I love the little... I like Monster Bots anyways. I almost bought Repugnus with that...
The Headmaster one?
Well, no, I almost bought... that's the one that I have in my hand. I almost bought the Fans Hobby one, because I still got to finish those guys. Because I had that $100 credit from where I bought the Robocop stuff.
Okay.
But then I saw they had the G2 Sever, who I can't find anywhere else, but somehow BBTS has it on sale. So I got that for like $83 after my free, you know, coupon.
Nice.
It wasn't really free, but it was. I paid retail for something that's been out of print for like 2 years, and I got $100 credit with it. I consider that a sale.
I got like $8 in source points from ordering that Fans Toys Skyfire, and I think I'm going to get some more Fans Toys through TF Source.
Yeah, what's this for the BBTS? I don't order from them very often, but they give, you know, with like a lot of the hot toys, like the Star Wars and the Robocop and shit, they give you like $100 credit with the order, and they're charging like regular price.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of like marking it up like you see it on eBay.
So, trying to decide on who I want to order next for Fans Toys, because I don't have a lot of the Fans Toys.
Cup?
No, I do not.
Get Cup. He's like $100. Get Cup.
Well, it's like I want to get Cup. I want to get Rouge.
Get Cup first.
I still need to get Omega. I'm
still going to say Cup, because Cup is easy. Cup's $100.
Right.
And I think he might be one that disappears, and then you have a hard time finding later, like Tesla.
Or Willis, yeah.
Yeah. No, you ain't got no trouble finding Willis.
No, nowadays.
It's not what you're talking about, Willis. It's why you're talking about Willis.
That reminds me, I should check Amazon Japan, see if the pre-order went up yet.
Oh, fucking shit. You know how high I am, guys? I forgot to fucking pick a TKO girl.
Oh, shit. So is your TKO girl Mary Jane?
Right now it is, until I find a suitable replacement.
Is your mind blown, dude?
It's like I see those fucking Target Masters on Amazon Japan, and it's like, yeah.
Which Target Masters?
The ones I have already, but the Slug Slinger, Misfire, and Trigger Happy.
Oh yeah, you know how happy I am to get that stupid shit.
What the fuck is this about?
Penis.
Bobby just shared a fucking post.
So do you have the Japanese releases or the American?
I have the American, man. I don't need the Japanese ones. I wish I had them because they come with the fucking Target Master.
Well, that's what I mean.
Hey, how much are they?
Let's see. 4,100 yen for that.
About $35.
And for this one, yeah, that's 4,500 yen. And for this one, 3,240 yen.
Man, we're gonna be getting fucking Target Masters over here soon, and I bet they do those guys Target Masters.
But they are doing one of them, but they did a completely new mold.
Yeah, they fucked it up. I know.
And it doesn't.
Oh, you're the right Takara. Fucking you. Here's your Headmaster.
And it doesn't match as well with our Slug Slinger or Trigger Happy, whichever one it is, as well as theirs do.
Mm-hmm. Hey, where is Dustin?
In Des Moines.
Oh, he's not coming on?
He didn't think he was going to be able to.
The hell's going on Des Moines? Is it on fire and everything's free?
His buddy's got a contracting job. He's got to help him out.
Make that money.
There's the Japanese wind blade. 3,900 yen.
It's the same, isn't it? Or is that from when they were still different?
Well, I'm sure it has remolding to accommodate. That's the thing. All the Target Masters in Japan had the remolding for a hole for the peg of the Target Master.
Mm. But, so where's our guest? Oh, he's not here yet. That's right. So it's just going to be us?
For a while.
Is the show actually happening right now?
It's recording, yeah.
Okay. We didn't even have an intro. Who's hosting this week?
Bugs.
Oh, come on. I want you to host. I didn't pick a TQ girl yet either. I guess I better pick something.
Yeah, I suppose I should pick something.
Mm. My TKO girl is that fucking Spider-Man playing soccer.
Dude, it's not even a KO, but it's the most fucking ridiculous shit I've ever seen.
Yeah, it's stupid as shit. Adventure hero. Sense of right alliance. Why does she love redheads?
I'm tempted to pick that midget.
No, don't pick the midget. Don't do that. What's wrong with you?
Why not? She needs love too. She's a fucking person.
They're not people. They're half a vote.
Ooh, have we found a race that you will not accept?
No, I'm just joking. I actually have a friend that's actually a dwarf.
You toss him?
No.
Have you ever fucking just gone, hi ho?
No, I've never done anything but be respectful to him. Oh, man.
Let's see. Okay, there's Chris's. Come on.
So, like, are we going to start the show, or are we going to wait to see if JC shows up?
I'm stretching a little bit just to give Phil a little bit more time.
Yeah.
Well, we know Phil's going to be late.
Yeah, no, I know, but the longer we vamp or wait or whatever, the less time he's not going to be on the show.
Mm-hmm.
No, I would think would be like kind of a crazy idea to try out one time. Like do a show, like do like a long like notes, you know, like a lot of shit, but set a timer so we have to finish it in a certain amount of time. And do like a race for the finish.
I like that.
We can do that at our post TFCon episode
because we'll do the 30 minute wrap up. That's a good idea. God, look at the set of legs on that. Hey, buddy.
Oh, okay.
I'm getting down there. Okay.
Some nice white meat there.
I ate so much, I got fucking sick last night.
Mm-hmm.
You want to get the gout?
Yeah, I know. I'm just playing with fire all the time, dude. It's almost like choking you during sex, you know? Mm-hmm. That might kill me, but goddamn, this is nice.
Not just right before I pass out next.
You know, unless you want to become a, you know, a Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Then choking him out's not cool.
Kind of want to get the Japanese cup.
Yeah, this house costs less than my car. Mm. Like payment wise, you know. Granted, you do this for 30 years, but
mm-hmm. Well, I fully intend if I end up getting a 30-year mortgage to pay it off in 15.
Well, if you need an investor, I'll dump out all the change in my cup holder every month and send it to you. My house costs that much a month to fucking insure. It costs more than that to insure and tax. That's actually like not a bad looking little house though.
Well, that's why I filled.
Yeah, it looks like the house I used to rent for like fucking $900 a month.
Ouch.
That's what that is right there. Down here, that's $900 to $1,000 a month.
Hmm.
At least. And yeah. I'm talking about in that condition. I'm not talking about fixed up and repainted and all that shit.
Dude, you should see some of the mansions I deliver on the Amazon road. It's fucking nuts.
Dude, Zillow's like, want to log in? Like Google shit? I'll log in and just buy it. It's $285 a month. I'll rent it out to you for like $900 a month.
Let's see. Price high to low. Here we go.
I want to buy a real slum for like $80 a month. Can you find me one? Like a $5,000 slum for $80 a month.
So here's one of the...
Hey, dude, it said get P qualified. I clicked it. It turned on my camera, took a photo, said you're qualified.
Here's one of the expensive ones.
Okay, send me that. It's like, hey, you're a human being. You have internet. You're qualified.
And it's even on sale. They knocked it down $91,000.
$2,700 a month. That's outside of my affordability.
But it's 6 bedroom, 6 bath.
That's huge. That's pretty big. How many square feet is it? 7,700.
Yep.
Yeah, my house is just under 3,000. And if I ever fucking finish it, that's a nice house.
Yeah, I don't need nothing that fancy. It's cool to look at, but no.
Not for near $2,700 a month. You know what, though? Because that means that something the size of my house would probably cost about what it costs down here, about two to three.
Like 100,000?
Yep.
Because you said how many square feet is yours?
It's almost 3,000. But that's a big lot. That's a nice freaking neighborhood here. I mean, my neighborhood's nice. There's nobody here. That's the best neighborhood.
Dude, I couldn't even tell you how many square feet is my fucking house.
3,000 square feet house here out in the country is 378,000.
Yeah, that's more. That's more. I mean, granted, on the beach, I bet they pay that much. But
well, that's just that there's no water around here. It's all hills, fields, and swamp.
Hmm.
And
yeah, I like y'all's. I want to send me some more of them little hood houses you got over there. I just bought a house in Detroit for $150.
You got his inner slumlord coming out.
Yeah, I need to become a slumlord. I'm really missing out. I bought it. It's only $48 a month, and I rent it out to Jim Bob for $5 a day.
Now, see, what you do is you get in on the Section 8 program.
No. Get that government.
So Jim Bob's $5 a day is automatically deposited in my account from the government. I could put about 14 Section 8 people in that mansion, though.
You know what? It always struck me funny because wasn't also a Section 8 what got Klinger out of the fucking army?
Got who out of the army?
Klinger out of the army. Mesh. Yeah.
I'm the only one that's ever watched that. I don't know nothing about it.
Here you go, JL. I got one for you in Milwaukee.
There you go. Well, I can't go to Milwaukee. The home of the beast. There we go. You know what? That's a $400 efficiency down here a month. $400 efficiency. It's already got, look, satellite TV.
And a classy fucking plywood front door.
Yeah, it's got a plywood security system. Concrete stairs. It's got a porch. It's probably got a sunroof.
The steps seem to be fortified with moss
and mold. There's no dead people in there.
At least
Michael Myers no longer lives there.
Is it what's a forgivable loan up to $20,000? I mean, you don't have to pay it.
It could be.
All right, well, sign me up. I don't even have to pay for it.
That's why this fucking country is in fucking problems, because people do shit like this.
Yeah, they're like, oh my God, it's only $2,500. They buy it, they go there. It doesn't come with the land. You got to move it. If it comes with the land, yeah, it includes the vacant lot behind it. So you can buy the lot and the land for $2,500. So you could tear that down, park a $10,000 trailer there, and start charge somebody like $500 a month for rent. And $2,500, that's not even a mortgage, man. Just fucking put on credit card.
But look, I can't fucking pony up $2,500 without seeing the inside.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, I'm assuming you have to tear it down. I'm assuming that vagrants lived in it for like 8 years with no running plumbing.
I want to see if Chris Partlow and Snoop fucking hit some bodies in the motherfucker.
Yeah. Like, I don't even think this should be property that's worth that much. You know, like, it should just be, like, just fucking burnt down at that point if it's only worth $2,500. I want to contact the agent. I want to click that I want financing information.
He's like, look, if you really want it, I'll cover it for you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, William Martin. I like, can I get this with no money down?
I wonder if the house next door is on fire currently while they were taking the
footage. I got a job, just not right now.
Oh, yeah.
It's not even Section 8, dude. It's like Section 4. Not even a full 8. It's like half a Section 8 charge.
Oh, here, God, that's bad.
If you were in earshot of anyone saying, now what had happened was, you know, some fucking shit's going down.
You know that there's been at least one meth lab explosion inside that building. They probably had to board the windows up. They probably blew out. I just like to imagine that Cheech and Chong live in there. You know, like retired Cheech and Chong live inside there. The only reason they didn't board the windows up all the way is so the smoke can get out.
So yeah, I've been keeping my on listings in my area.
Why don't you just buy this for your down payment?
No.
Dude, that might be a tennis table top that they use the fucking board up.
Yeah, it is. They stole it from the rec center. Boarded up there. Damn, that railing on the side of the stairs looks like it's made out of coat hangers or something.
Post-abortion use.
Yeah, you know, that's somebody's dream home. That's some homeless guy's dream home. I'm going to assume it needs a roof. Facts and features. Year built, 1900. Okay, we'll take that. Has plastic siding, but that's fine, whatever. Heating is forced air. It's whatever air you can force out your lungs and into the building.
Is fucking part of the porch coming off?
Yeah.
Could be.
The back end.
Like, the lot is the same size as my house. It saves 5 people. Okay. It's only $2 a square foot, Bugs. That's less than like a fucking Subway sandwich.
It
has a detached garage. It's because they detached it and moved it.
It doesn't come with the satellite dish.
It doesn't? Oh, shit. Never mind, I want my deposit back. I want $40. Type is a single family. I think it should be a single person. No data on the cooling. What the hell does forced air mean for heating?
You've never heard of forced air heating?
No.
Yeah, it means it's pushing air through your house, through a system of vents.
So central air.
Yeah, exactly.
That thing don't have central air, dude. Somebody already scrapped that shit for the copper. Paid for the rent last month. Is that a patch of mold or a payphone stuck on the post on the front of the building? You see it? What is that? It might be a cat.
I think it's one of those cat clocks that the eyes go back and forth.
Yeah, the haunted cat clock from Pulse. It's been on Zillow for over 2 years. This photo is not even current.
But the
lender is unknown and taking ownership of this property. The lender might be a pawn shop. I'll loan you $50 on it.
Actually, it's kind of funny. There's a post office available that's for sale.
How much is that?
$60,000.
Oh, no. Wait, can you actually run it as a post office, or is it just a building?
No, the post office rents the front part of it, and it says in the listing that the post office pays $315
a month. $315
a month? Yeah.
For parking space?
No. Yeah, I'll show you. I'll show you the listing here.
You know what? The South is way better than up there. That's the post office?
That's a post office in the village of Blanker.
The green building.
The one I just posted.
No, I don't think you... I don't.
The post office is in the front of that building.
Hang on, man. Let me look at it. Oh, all right. Yeah, that's different. Why no, the second one was that other $2,500 one that's actually pretty large.
Why do you fucking oversized hobbits got to call it a fucking village? Can't it just be a town?
A township is actually a district of rural area. So, like, where I live, it's the village of Spencer. But when you leave the village of Spencer, if you go north, that's the town of Brighton. If you go to the south, that's the town of Spencer. And if you go to the west, that's the town of... I can't think of that one. But they're all their own municipalities, and they all have their own local forms of government.
It looks like they got halfway through renovating it and then quit.
On this post office? Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's fucking huge.
I don't want to live in a town where the post office only has to pay $300 worth of fucking rent to be there. Fuck that town. That town sucks.
It is a small, it's a very small village.
That better be the whole town in the picture if they're only paying $300 a month for the post office.
There's like 100 people that live in that village.
It's got an attached garage.
And they're only there Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Yeah. Probably. Well, the mortgage would only be $263 a month. They'd be paying your mortgage for you.
Basically, yeah.
It's probably taxes. You know what happens? Is they probably charge you like business taxes on that shit, and it's like $1,500 a month. There's always a catch. Probably zoned as commercial, and you got to pay commercial taxes on it.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
That's confusing. It almost looks like it has two different kitchens, so I don't know if it's meant to be a duplex or...
I think it might be a before and after photo, even.
Or a soup kitchen. You feel at home.
Yeah, there's a soup kitchen right in the back out for $50 a month. Does it come with the workout equipment? Because I'm going to want to get swole if I'm going to live there.
Comes with a needle exchange box.
Yeah.
Ooh, this one doesn't look...
That's how that greenhouse looks haunted as fuck, dude. We should do actually do a show about shitty fucking homes for sale on the internet. I think I see something, some dollar signs here. We could actually buy one of these houses with a Patreon. You know what I mean? For just $10 a month, you can have partial ownership of the shitty house we were talking about.
It's a timeshare.
Yeah.
I found a really nice one that's cheap, but it's in Greenwood, and that's a little ways away.
It's only $3 a month for your timeshare, but you only get the first and second week at the end of the end in the beginning of the year.
Oh man, I wish that one was in Marshfield, but if it was, it'd be way more than what it is.
There's another one.
Sad.
No, that's the post office again.
No, I didn't post the one I was looking at.
You gotta post more shitty houses, man. Now you got me curious.
Well, this one's a nice one. Nice little one that I like, but it's a little...
There you go.
I'd be increasing my commute a little bit.
That is a little tiny house, though. I think that's the biggest room I'm in right now.
Well, that's just it.
No, that's like what I said, that's a $800-$900 rental down here.
Well, and that's only counting the square footage on the first floor, because it's got a full finished basement.
Is that the garage goes with it too, huh?
Yeah, and it's got a two-car garage. But if you get to...
Oh my god, I hope they take all that shit out of the house. Look at those decorations.
Yeah,
get out of here. Oh my god.
Picture 10 and 11, that's in the basement.
There's like a 94-year-old hoarder that lives in that house.
Dude, I got a hoarder on the mail road.
How do they make like 8 rooms out of that shit? Look at the room. Mm-hmm. I'm assuming they're just standing in the middle of one big room and turning around taking pictures.
Dude, it's not bad though.
No, it's not at all. Not for $200-something a month. And it doesn't look like it's all beat to hell either.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to hope the current owner don't die in it before you buy it.
They'll never get that smell out.
Oh no, you can see the photos on the wall. Wait, those are probably their kids though.
That's just if I go to my Google Maps here and see how much it increases my...
Now you're going to leave that picture of Jesus up on the wall if you buy it?
So, directions from Greenwood.
I want to see Dallas take a fucking jump on that butterfly. Just hang there.
Yeah. What is up? Was this thing a fire station with them red-ass fucking plugs in the wall? That's what that is. That butterfly is taking a big giant red shit that has outlets on the bottom of it.
But I'll be right back, guys. I gotta stop for a second.
Uh-oh. I can't believe you can buy a house for like under $300 a month.
There are some fucking depressed areas.
Well, that place don't look bad though, unless your neighbor is a fucking crack dealer. And even if it is a crack dealer, for that much money, I wouldn't care.
These people kept this house up.
Mm-hmm.
It may need some shit done, but most houses do anyway, so.
Yeah, but that house has like a $1,000 roof on it if you have to replace a roof. It's like fucking four squares.
Get a couple box of fucking graham crackers.
Mm-hmm. I roofed it entirely of those vacuum bags you put your sweaters in. I stuck it on top of the roof and I hooked the vacuum up to it.
I got help carry some stuff down to the basement, so it was a couple minutes.
All right, cool. Yeah, I can't believe that. Maybe I should downsize. Fucking stop paying just giant mortgage and taxes every year.
But where will the details go?
In Bugs' house. Yeah, I know. Like, I've always liked having a lot of space, though. That's kind of like just, I don't know.
Yeah, I need more fucking space, but I refuse to move.
Yeah, like my grandparents' house was tiny.
The house I grew up in was fucking tiny. Same with my grandparents. You know, people fucking survived with like 5-6 kids in a fucking
two-bedroom houses.
Yeah.
Not me. My mom, we grew up in a 3-bedroom house. I had a room, my sister had a room, my mom had a room. We had it pretty good, all things considered. Yeah, I'm legit. I'm going to start a GoFundMe for this fucking Kirk. I'm tired of watching it. Dude, that motherfucker went, this was like a bidding auction. It wasn't like a buy it now. The motherfucker still went for $365.
Hmm.
I won't pay that much. I don't want to pay that much for it. But like, I really have to because I'm already in like the rest of them. I own the rest of the fucking series.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I need to just do it, but I don't want to.
I'm the same way with the fucking Quintessence.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm back.
Nice.
That was quick.
We're going to start a GoFundMe, and with the money, we're either going to buy you a house or buy me that Kirk.
Well, it's like I'm looking at the map, and if I lived in Greenwood and worked in Marshfield, I'm looking at...
What about if you lived in Detroit?
A 30-mile commute.
That's what I do every day, dude. But you'd be 30-mile commuting to a $300-a-month house.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a bad idea.
Well, right now I have a 10-mile commute, so.
Yeah, you're talking your own place for $300 a month.
Yeah.
And I bet your power bill is like $50 fucking dollars.
And with all the driving you do anyway, delivering,
yeah,
a little extra mileage every day going to be a thing.
Well, I suppose not. Of course, if I'm going to live that far away. I probably prefer to live in Loyal. That's at least a little closer. And that's where that one house is, the nice one bedroom.
Yeah, like I said, I can't believe that you can. I didn't even know houses were that cheap anywhere. I mean, I've heard about the houses for $500 and like the edges of Detroit that have been burned down and shit, but.
Uh-huh.
Why would you need a virtual reality web browser? Mozilla launches a VR browser. Because when I want to use my VR, I want to spend it surfing the same internet I can surf on my fucking phone.
This one,
I think they do it for walkthroughs of the house.
Oh, that would be cool.
The current owner of this house seems to have a hunting issue.
Are you going to share pictures?
Yeah, there's a lot of dead animals in it.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? The good news is there's a lot of dead animals in the other ones, too. You want dead animals. That $2,500 one has some dead animals in it, too. I guarantee you.
How goddamn disgusting was that fucking baked mouse thing?
Yeah, oh, that was gross.
God, oh, the cooked mouse?
Yeah.
Nasty. How do you get a hole that high up in the ceiling, in the wall? See the hole way above the cabinets?
Let's see.
Oh, wow.
I didn't see that. I'm wondering if that's where they had a fire...
another head?
And fucking smoke detector, hardwired. Because that's what we got here at this house. They're hardwired here.
Oh, that's actually a pretty good sized little house, dude. You could rent out the upstairs, the dirt. Have him move out there. You can live upstairs.
But it is interesting that their whole curtain system for the laundry that's in the dining room there.
What is it?
If you look at picture 4, there's curtains there, and then you go to picture 5, and that's where the washer and dryer are.
That's fine.
Curtains. You can always.
Looks like he just cut the hole out in the fucking wall and built it. See that?
That's what it looks like. Yes.
Hey, do we need insulation? Oh fuck no! Cut it all out. And we'll put the washer and dryer over there. The curtains will keep the heat in the house.
You can always put bifolds on.
You gotta do something to that doorway though. Look at that; it's all jagged.
Yeah, you gotta fucking finish it off first.
Yeah, you always got to finish it off. Look at this. They cut every entryway in the house. Look at the one above the bear. It's like a seagull. Yeah. Right, this used to be a 15-room house. They cut all the walls out of it. It was like a mid-1800s orphanage. And after the ghost stopped haunting it, they started cutting the walls out of it to make it work. Look at the home office. You got a home office, Bugs. It even comes with the chair that the man sat in naked for 5 years.
Screws.
You could measure how long his dick is by the stain of the sweat in the fucking chair. Yeah. But like I said, once again, that house is cheap as shit. Unless it's completely roach infested, I could probably deal with it. Well, upstairs, you could put your collection upstairs.
Well, and that's why I want at least a 2-bedroom, so I have a place to put the robots.
Look at that leaning over shelf upstairs. You see it? It's like the ones from Walmart that you put the little totes in. There's nothing in it. It's kind of leaning over. How do you even bend that?
Look at that fucking bear, man.
I know that.
He's posed like, who the fuck's that?
The guy was in the forest. Hey, anybody interested in... Pay $150 to be a homeowner. Yeah, you ever seen a deer before?
I've seen deer.
No, I'm talking about the bear. He's asking the bear if you ever seen a deer before.
That is an interesting decorating choice.
Yeah, all the fucking turkey feathers and there's one of those guys is like 1/18th Cherokee. You guys have all the animal spirits in the house.
I could always get a double wide.
You know what though? For what it costs for these little houses, why would you buy a trailer?
It's not a trailer per se, but it is manufactured.
Well, this is a double wide house. It's twice as wide as the one that was $2,500.
I'll show you, and it's got issues too. Particularly the last picture.
If nobody else shows up, we should just cut this shit off at 10 o'clock and just put it on the internet. This is our show.
Dude, this is fucking going out. I'm fully planning on just
leaving this in here.
This is the whole fucking intro.
Nice. Maybe this should be like a bonus after the end of the show. This house don't look too bad either, man.
Keep going.
Whoa, it's got mold. Oh, that's what's in my garage, but the rest of my house was spared. Oh, it's been flooded before. There was water up on the walls. Yeah, that house has been underwater before. Or a water main blew up in it or something.
There's no water to be underwater in this area, yeah. That's what I mean.
Well, I mean, rivers flood and shit.
There's not even a river. If anything, I don't even know if there's something you can consider a creek going through town.
That's what sucks, because this house is kind of nice, but you get enough of that shit, they'll condemn it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the whole thing. Now, do not turn on without refilling.
But yeah, that's clearly a manufactured ranch.
Winterize a hot water heater unless the place is fucking vacant.
Look at that fucking mold.
Yeah. It's not so much mold, it's free decoration for the ceiling.
It's the pepper on the popcorn ceiling.
For that much money, no, because there's so many other houses you showed us that like are that size almost and the same price or cheaper and probably don't have mold issues.
Right. Dude,
what the fuck kind of drywalling pattern were they fucking using here?
Which one? Which room are you talking about? They're all different.
This is the washrooms. It's the one with the outlets for the washer. The pipes.
I'm looking for it.
The water supply. It's 26.
No, I don't know what that is. I saw that. You know what that is? That's that cabinet liner you buy from the dollar store. They just bought some of it and glued it to the wall. It's the nice sticky rubber stuff.
And there's a fucking Slim Jim on top of the black box over there.
Yeah. Somebody's hungry, man. That picture's not that old either. Oh, that mold could have taken over the whole house by now.
Could have. I'd seen one. It's not listed anymore, but there was one that was much worse. Like, with those manufactured ones, typically they haul them out in halves and then they have to seal them up at the pitch of the roof, and somebody didn't do a good job sealing it because it came right through the middle.
Gross.
It was bad. So yeah, that's the kind of shit I've been seeing when I've been looking for a house. So
has been house hunting on HGTV.
It's almost like fate, isn't it?
But I suppose we could probably start the show because Phil's going to be on here shortly.
Yeah, we can go ahead and do that.
So we got no Dustin, no JC Guestin.
That's quite all right. Are you ready to go, Bugs?
I guess.
All right, then. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Good.
Since the dawn of time, things have happened. People have talked about those things. First with cave paintings, then with language, writing, and art. In our time, we use the internet. From the depths of nerddom come four guys who talk about things too. World famous internet celebrity Justin L. The destroyer of BotCon, Deadbugs. The guy that learned how to mow grass in the prison yard, DA. And the customizing powerhouse, Mako Aspire. And Tyler F. And every so often, a man who rejects the concept of catch and release, Justin Catfish. This is Tubular Knockoff.
This is Bedbugs, and welcome to TKO episode number 59.
59.
We're getting closer and closer to 65, where we can finally retire.
Yeah.
They're pushing it up to 67.
Oh, shit.
Well, I'm sorry to our listeners, then. All right, so as always, well, I guess not always, because somebody called in and somebody's still not here. And
somebody offered to sub and called in.
I'm just going to be frank, fellas. This show's going to be a fucking train wreck.
But yay!
Why?
Let's light some fires and let's get it going. So, how you doing, JL?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful, other than I have a developing cough, and I apologize for any unwanted sound effects as we're recording.
Yay!
So, did you get any goodies this week?
Yeah, I did get a few things. I got the Amazon exclusive Punch Counter Punch.
Bastard. And
so far, I'm pretty impressed with that guy. You know, it is what you're used to. It's a, you know, Hasbro chug, but it works. I mean, you turn him around, you move some shit, he's punch. Mm-hmm. Turn him back around, move some shit, he's counter punch.
Unlike the other one, the Generations one, this one actually takes into account the fucking shoulder was actually a feature.
Mm-hmm.
So they have both shoulder modes too.
So did you have to do the shoulder fix on yours?
Not yet.
So you didn't notice which way the ball joints on the shoulders were assembled?
Well, however they're assembled, they turn around and turn into counterpunch. So I guess they're right.
Because some people had theirs that were assembled incorrectly or had one correct and one incorrect. So then they had to take the screws out, pull the torso apart, and rotate it around, because I guess there's a flat side on one side and a round side on the other on the hinge that the ball joint is on. And if it's facing the one way, it makes it a lot easier to get in the car mode than it does the other.
Well, I guess I'll find out when I turn into car mode.
Oh, yeah,
I'm going to give them credit because it would have been really easy just to make hands that have two thumbs so that you could just flip it around and it would work.
You mean like the combiner fist?
Yeah, but they actually, his hand, you know, because his hands also turn from red to blue.
Mm-hmm.
And they actually did put a set of rotating hands that go inside the forearm to switch the hands over when you switch into, you know, switch them back and forth from his two bot modes.
Good on that.
Nice. I mean, they could have done so much. They could have saved a nickel there and not done that and just made him have a thumb on the bottom of the hand. But
like
they didn't.
Like Fun Pub.
Yeah, they also could have painted the top of the hand red and the bottom of it. I mean, we've seen shit like that before, like stupid shit like that. Mm-hmm. But it works.
Did you, either of you have the original G1?
Oh, yeah.
I have a Junker G1 in my tote somewhere.
By the time I knew he actually came with a gun, I was already a man.
I like that. I actually really like that toy.
Yeah, that's a good toy. I actually, you know, there's a period where I didn't really play with Transformers. But, like, I still had that thing sitting around, and I would still mess with it. Like, I might have been a teenager. It was just laying on my counter in my room, and I was kind of over Transformers by then. I wasn't one of the guys that was, like, lifelong. It's something that, like, I gave up when I became a young adult, and then I got back into
childish things.
Yeah, I threw them all away for binge drinking and abusing my body and making financial decisions. And then I finally matured and started buying toys. So, but yeah, he's pretty good. And I also got I finally opened the Repugnus that also came from the same line.
Yeah.
And today I got in also Iron Factory. I finally got a couple legends. I had pre-ordered the Amethyst from Iron Factory, which is the Purple Seeker. I think that's, was it Flame War? What's his name? The Purple Seeker.
Purple Seeker, which one?
That's the Flame guy, the Fire guy.
Okay, so you have Sunstorm, and then you have
Hot Link.
Yeah, Hot Link.
Yeah, Hot Link. I said Hot Lip. Hot Link. I had a drink. I'm having a drink. So.
All right, starting with the MASH references.
And I also got the Shrike's Feather, which is their little tiny slipstream, which I do like that mold a lot. That's the Windblade mold. I got her because she was cheap as shit, and I already had pre-ordered this, and he's like, give me like a little bit of money, I'll throw it in the box with it. I'm like, okay, cool. I got these from GCI Toys. Oh. Mr. Peniche.
Yeah, I just placed an order this evening.
And so yeah, I'm glad I got these. I haven't had to mess with them yet, but they look really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if I get into Legends, I'll probably be ordering from GCI, but I haven't gotten into Legends yet.
I'm trying. It's a fight for me not to buy all the MS toy shit coming out. Cause I haven't bought any of them yet, and I really like them. But like I just so much other stuff I could buy with what it would cost to catch up on that. You know what I mean? And I think that's all I got this week. I did get a roof contract. That's kind of nice.
Oh, nice.
So I'll probably have that started in about 2 weeks because right now they're backed up. And that's it.
All right. And then our second normal host member, whatever.
Normal, quotation marks.
Whatever you want to call him. Just don't call him late for dinner.
Yeah.
Mako Aspire, how you doing, sir?
I'm all right. How are y'all?
We're good.
Great. I'm sorry. I'm distracted. I'm trying to help Phill get in.
Oh. I thought the dog was like bothering you.
Yeah, my fucking dog stays upstairs. I got a baby gate that I can go open it, swing open door, and it closes behind me. All that shit. Fucking dog will come down here.
So every time you walk upstairs, do you start hearing "In the arms of an angel"?
What the fuck are you talking about?
You know the Sarah McLachlan, the
oh, that fucking rescue animal, fucking
yes.
Shit.
Your dog's not looking through the gate. And...
Well, I don't consider this dog like a rescue so much because he was, apparently his story is, he was bought for an older gentleman who like maybe just lost his fucking wife or been alone for a while, and somebody wanted to give him a fucking dog and he just couldn't care for it. So he made it to this place that rescues dogs. And they've done like over 1,000 of them.
Giving a dog as a gift is like giving a cell phone as a gift. It's something that, while nice, it's something you're going to have to continue to fucking pay for after it's been given.
Yeah.
No, giving a dog as a gift is like giving somebody herpes. You're never getting rid of it.
Nah, I bet you could.
Well, eventually.
Yeah.
Not before it does irreparable damage to your life.
All right, and we are working on getting our guest signed in here.
Well, why don't you take care of that, so I'll tell you what I got.
All right.
I did not get anything toy related. Everything that I've purchased recently is still en route. What I did get, however, is a backup to the most trusted marijuana vaporizer that I have ever owned, and I've owned several. My original is still going strong. It's the Airizer Solo 2. It's a nice compact design. It's got a glass mouthpiece. Heats up well. It heats up pretty fucking high if you wanted to burn it. But I'm just trying to get the vapor out of it. But again, there's nothing wrong with my original. It's about 6 years old now, so I'm just getting the fucking... I'm getting the pitcher warmed up, kids. Getting the clothes are coming.
And this is one you can legally have now, right?
I'm working on that, actually.
Nice.
But, yeah, I'll be having this in TFCon Chicago.
What about the dog? Gonna bring the dog?
Only if I can fucking hang it from the back of the plane.
Ooh.
I'm kidding. Goddamn National Lampoon's fucking picture.
Actually, if you want to get rid of the dog, make sure you just bring it with and fly United.
Oh my god, man. I'm not even that bad. Jesus Christ.
All right. Still no sign of Phill yet.
I mean, you did post the
I think he thinks that we're using Skype or something. Maybe.
Is there a way to add his email to this call?
You gotta click in.
Hold on. I might be able to do that.
So the link takes him to the Play Store.
Alright.
Oh, he doesn't have it on his phone. He's probably on an iPhone. Can't even do it. Well, no. JC uses the iPhone to get on here, doesn't he?
I just sent him a fucking a direct link for a direct invite. It did allow me to do it. You on a phone or on a PC, sir?
If he says, like, you know, Apple computer.
PC would be better.
And somebody's got that MP Black Rodimus on Facebook for $115 shipped. That's pretty cheap. So don't want it?
No.
I want that busted kneed bastard.
I got the one from the Powder Primes line, and that one is actually pretty decent. Solid
toy. I've always liked this figure though.
I have yet to get any of the leaders from the Powder Primes line.
Powder Primes!
That Comic-Con Primal was going to be my first one, but Hasbro Toy Shop fucked up, so whatever.
You got gang, son!
But, alright, well, I guess we will start with the news while we wait to try to get our guest on here. Apologize for the technical difficulties.
That is also part of what our fucking thing is. It's part of our brand now. We have so much technical problems.
Yeah.
59 episodes in and we're still fucking up.
We don't even know if the shows are making it online. We're just assuming they make it on there every now and then because people talk about it.
So, speaking of shit, our first item that has shown up on the interwebs, I have no idea who's making this or what it's called, but we have a transforming toilet.
It is a called Toiletron!
I think it's really cool, though. I need that on my desk at work.
So it's clearly a not American style toilet because it's got to be Japanese style, I assume. And the robot mode looks almost like a Japanese version of Dirt Boss from Animated. Like Dirt Boss from Animated if he had a Shogun's mask on, because the body is very short and so are the legs, but the head is huge.
And he's got a diaper on too. Big old diaper full of poop.
Kind of looks like a fucking old He-Man fucking character. I can't remember.
His name was Shitor.
I'm going to call this Hideyoshi Toilet Tomy. And if you know Japanese history, that's funny.
What about us that didn't take Japanese history in college?
Hideyoshi Toyotomi was Japanese warlord.
Oh, nice. Just like General So.
General So didn't exist.
Yeah, whatever. You tell the people that sell it to me.
Why don't you describe the alt mode to people?
So, poop. I didn't, like I said, it's a Japanese style toilet, so it has a lot more in the back than what an American toilet does.
Yeah, it does.
Now why would it? Why? What does that do to add to function of the toilet?
I have no idea.
It double as a rice cooker.
I think it's just because that's the only way they can make a toilet out of this guy.
Well, and if you'll notice, like the base of the bowl of the toilet doesn't touch the ground. Now, that's typical for some of the public restroom toilets here that are like football shaped, but to see it on a round one like that just is unsettling.
The toilet's actually the front, and the rest of it is the rest of that $900 efficiency in Milwaukee you can buy for $300 a month.
So this thing comes with a couple of katanas, it looks like, and it comes with toilet paper that sits on top, and it even comes with a poo inside the toilet bowl.
Now, is the poo removable?
I assume so.
So can you flush it?
I have no idea.
Probably not.
I'm kidding. Jesus Christ. Literal motherfuckers.
But, I'm kind of curious if we'll see the prototype at DFCon now.
Yeah, I hope so. Oh my god. If they have it, I think I want to get it, but I have seen the price on it. It's a little prohibitive. Sorry. It's like $68.
For that toilet?
Yeah.
That's too much for that toilet.
So this is like a deluxe size toilet.
Yeah, I hope. You know what? I wish it was leader size. I'd pay $68 for it.
You know,
for a toilet big enough for an MP Prime to take a shit in.
If we could get confirmation on the scale of the toilet itself,
I'll link. There is a picture with a Deadpool, but I'm not sure what figure line that Deadpool's from.
Okay, so we need a Matthew Baldwin figure in that size scale.
Yeah, we do.
And then everyone can have their own toilet selfie Baldwin. So,
you know, there's kind of a, if you look at the poo picture, it's kind of like a fucking monkey little face. You see the little eyes right there on the back of the toilet, and then looks like the mouth there. And I'm not saying anything about Matt, but I can see it saying, "Hey there, everybody."
That's funny.
Actually, if you lift the toilet lid up and you have those two spots that look like eyes, they almost look like something that came out of Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Yeah, it does.
Ooh, you know, well, there was Cherry, so there would have to be fucking Throny in the fucking toilet.
Throny.
Or Johnny.
Johnny, here you go. Johnny.
Hey, Johnny, I'm going to take a shit in you, okay? Jesus Christ.
I didn't know you could do that impression either. That's a magic word! Just do that for like another hour, and then we're just going to close the show out.
Still no sign of Phill. Hmm. Well, this is disappointing.
Yeah, he needs to get on here.
Let's try sending another message.
Let's try sending a letter to you, Phill Hamilton. You're invited. Come play with us.
Like I said, this is going to be a train wreck. But... well,
it always is whenever we try and fucking add somebody later.
Yeah, we have to have everybody from the start from now on.
And look, the Google Hangouts thing is working out. It's pretty cool. You know, it's easy to use, easy to do what I got to do with on the back end of it. So I'm fine with it. So we just have to figure out why people can't click in.
I got a question for you guys since we're waiting.
Okay.
You ever see those posts that are like, oh, have a medical emergency, like ER fucking shit. And then they got like, you know, $180 worth of stuff for sale.
What?
Like, oh. Like, do you believe them?
No.
Do you think anybody's paying an ER bill with $180 worth of transformer sales?
Yo, man, I got $180 worth of heroin.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's like, you know, like if I was like, you know, my medical bills, I got a medical bill. Everything needs to go. I'd have a picture of my fucking motorcycle and car up there. Maybe that would cover most of it.
Yeah.
Who's paying the medical bills for $180?
Well, it's pay as you go. It's that, you know, culture, just like the phones.
Or you luck out and have very cheap copays because you're poor.
Well, I have very cheap copays, but it's not an emergency if it's a copay.
I don't know. I've only seen one that I've legit believed because I know the guy and he had a car problem and then he started selling figures and then he found out that the car problem wasn't as severe as he thought it'd be. So he ended up with money in his pocket for no reason, but
Well, I mean, it's your toys. You can sell them if you want.
Right.
But it's like, I don't know of very many $180 medical emergencies.
All right, well.
Let's move on to our second news item, I guess. We'll keep trying to get Phill in here. But our second item in the news is, oh, who didn't see this coming? Guardian Sentinel repaint of the ugly-ass Wei Jing Omega Supreme.
Honestly, I think in this color scheme, it's probably better.
I think it's better in the pile of trash.
But if it still remains like at $250 or $260, like it's fucking actually good.
Does anybody else still get a little chub when they think about when all those people that said they were going to hold them out as their heroes at the $100 Omega, and then it was like $200? anybody still get a little boner when all the nerds cried at once?
When they realized that this piece of shit was just as much as the Fans Toys version?
Yeah. God, that was great. I wish we could go back to that moment for a minute.
It kind of was bullshit, though, because they did come out and say it's going to be around $100.
Yeah, and then it wasn't. It was $180 plus shipping.
But who knows? You know, maybe nobody officially said it was going to be around $100, but that got out and became the pervasive idea.
Well, you can only assume that since it's Wei Jang and it looks like it, you know, has less complexity than like the MPP-10 did, that it's only around the same price or cheaper.
Now, if this was like $100, I could see a lot of guys like troop building this to go with their actual Fans Toys Omega. But
if this was $100, I would get it if I had the room for it.
Mm-hmm. Well, you do now. You got all that put it on top of that baby gate at the top of the stairs.
Jesus Christ.
See if you can keep the dog away.
Dog will never be down here. Ever.
What about its ashes? Will its ashes be down there?
Nope.
Jeez, that's harsh, man.
So, with this being a repaint, do you think they're going to do a discount on it, or do you think they're even going to charge a premium on it?
It'll be a little bit cheaper, I bet. Like, $20 cheaper. Mm. God, I love thinking about all those nerds crying, though, man. God, that makes me happy. Passing on two of them, only to find out that the one they thought was going to be way cheaper looked worse and cost the same. Oh, yeah.
What if they do that Diaclone version? Because I got to think Wei Jing is going to try to repaint this a couple of
times. I want the converters black and red. Somebody make that. I want to put that bitch with my shitty collection of converters bots.
So even if it's Wei Jing that does it first?
I don't know if it necessarily has to be the first.
What if we get...
There we go.
Oh, there. Oh, hey, I got it on my phone.
We got it. Yay.
Guys, I'm sorry. That took forever.
That's all right.
You can shut off the video if you like.
It's all right. It's episode 59, and I just figured out how to get on the show.
So, for those that are unaware, our guest this evening is Mr. Phill.
Phill Robertson.
Family Robertson, sure. Hey, guys. Love the show. I listen to a lot of podcasts at my work, and you guys have really easily made it my favorite.
Awesome.
So it's really an honor to be on here. But you know what? I bought my way on, Eric, didn't I? So
I was gonna ask you to come on before you even offered that up. Because we were looking for guests.
What did you give that job?
No, nothing like that. Did you get that in the mail, Eric, today?
Not today, no, I didn't. I didn't go get the mail today. I went and got it yesterday, and it wasn't there. So.
You don't even get your own mail? That's lazy.
I figured you'd have connections where you could actually, you know, get something early, but, oh, Wisconsin mail carriers, you know.
Yeah.
But for those who are wondering, DairyCon has been releasing these miniature Constructicon repaints, and they merged to form Constructimus Prime, which is... Fred's running joke that kind of spoofs the Fun Pub's first exclusive they did, that combiner that turned into a Prime. So he's been releasing one figure here and there, and it's been a couple of years now, and I've managed to acquire 4 of the 6. And right. he did the last member of the group at the fall special, and I wasn't able to go to it because I had to work. And Phill was able to go, and he managed to snag one, and he hooked me up with it.
Nice. All right,
nice. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, so it's not like... the last one? You still need one more?
I still need Tipsy, the long haul repaint, and then I'll have all 6.
Now, did you pay the man back?
I offered to pay, but he wanted to come on instead, and I wasn't going to argue with him.
Yeah, we're kind of backwards, I guess, a little bit here in Wisconsin.
Wait a minute, have you heard of quantum mechanics?
I took it in high school and forgot everything.
Oh, never mind.
So
they make a Kirk figure. It's rather nice. I'm missing that if you want to be on the show again. Hell, you know what? I'll trade you my spot on the show if you buy it.
Wow.
I'm out. I'm joking.
So did you get any goodies for yourself this week, sir?
Goodies, yes. After getting a cold and a flat tire, I got a flat screen TV in a contest.
Nice.
So, yeah, I'm happy about that.
How big?
50-inch Vizio LED. It's one of the Ultra HD 4K ones.
Wow, nice. Dude. How'd you win that?
So I was at a wrestling show in La Crosse, one of the local promotions, and they have it at the American Legion, and at the bar, I bought 2 pull tabs, and out of 100, they won.
Sweet.
Nice.
Yeah, happy about that.
So what local wrestling promotion is down there? Because I've gone to Wisconsin Professional Wrestling, and that's in Green Bay.
Right, WWE's great. We have RCCW, which is River City Championship Wrestling.
Okay.
Yeah, I go to them all the time. Wrestling is another passion of mine, so I really enjoy that. In fact, I work for a DJ service that goes around to different promotions and, does the music for them and everything.
Okay. Yeah, an old friend of mine from high school is actually one of the wrestlers in WPW, and he's got his own promotion. I think it's called Frontline Pro Wrestling, and he's going to be having an event here in Marshfield, I believe, in October.
What does WTW stand for?
What the what?
Yeah,
I said WPW. It's Wisconsin Professional Wrestling.
I thought you said WTW. I was like, what the hell does WTW mean?
No. Apparently, we've been kind of slow to embrace the local wrestling circuits like the South and Ohio have, and it's now starting to kind of take more mainstream up here in Wisconsin.
It sure has. There's a lot of guys that are bringing up promotions, and it's starting to get a little crowded, actually, because right. They're pretty territorial. But, as a DJ service, that kind of works for us because, we'll bounce around to anybody. So, I'm going to try. I'll see if I can make it up to Marshfield and see what kind of business they're doing.
Yeah, I'll have to shoot you a link for the event. So did you get any other goodies besides the TV?
I got some top loaders that fit the oversized cards for the Transformers card game. That's really it.
Did you get the card game or something already?
So I bought on eBay somebody who was selling at Gen Con the starter set and the exclusives. So I've been kind of practicing a little bit because I'm a gamer also, and I really want to kind of get into this one because it mixes the two passions I got. Pretty well. So
nice.
So like, were you like buying like the Hascon exclusives, the Grimlock magic cards and stuff like that?
No, I never got into magic. I did see that and it looks cool.
You know what you can do?
It's going to be a whole different game.
You can go get yourself some printable card stock, go online and find the pictures of them, just print them out.
Yeah.
Right. You could do the proxies for sure. But that probably would be cheaper. But if I want to show up at TFCon or something and play an actual game, you know, I don't know if they're plan on doing some sort of events. They might require the actual cards. I don't know.
So are you coming down to TFCon next month?
I'm hoping so. Because my daughter is in gymnastics and dance competitions, I will know next week when things will be placed. I have to put everything on hold until I get those dates. I'm hoping.
My condolences, man. I've been there with the fucking dance, then the acro, and now it's fucking cheerleading. It's all over the fucking place.
Oh, she's really deep into that stuff, and it's great to cheer her on and everything, and but that it's nothing like I knew as a kid. This is it's all brand new to me, and oh, it's a bit overwhelming, but you know, I'm there for her.
Mm-hmm. All right, so while you were on your way home, the only thing we went through was the two news items. The first was that Japanese toilet transformer. I assume you've seen that when Fred posted it.
Yeah, it's got like a Japanese demon type thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
So are you interested in the third-party toilet bot?
No. No, I definitely want Fred's toilet bot, though, but not this one.
Did you buy any slums this week?
We were talking about shitty houses in Wisconsin as well.
There's been a ton of those around here, just because of the flooding and everything, like, people are moving out of the area. It's crazy.
And then the other item in the news was Wei Jing's Omega Sentinel repaint of their Omega Supreme. You've seen the original one, right? The piece of shit?
Yeah. Yeah, I almost bought that one from you, too. I still need an Omega Supreme, and it's got to be big. Omega Sentinel, you know, yeah, DX9 is the one that I've been focused on, but just haven't pulled the plug yet.
I like the fans' toys.
Mm.
You can't really go wrong. You just kind of pick which one you think looks the best to you.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, like, I haven't heard any bad things about either, unless, you know, you got a waterlogged one.
So, the Omega Sentinel, that's pretty much, you know, what Omega Supreme used to be, right? You know, if you follow the cartoon, they were just, you know, a bunch of the big robots.
Basically a generic Seeker repaint for a Guardian robot is what it is.
Mm-hmm. So if you would have to get a bunch of them.
There were a bunch of them in G1, but they were all blue like this.
Yeah, blue and gray. Right.
Yeah, I don't know if I liked that episode that much where I need, you know, a bunch of them or even one of them, honestly.
Yeah, and if you really wanted to have a representation in your collection, you'd always get McFans Toys, the little blue one.
Yeah, the little legends.
Mm-hmm. Just have it on the fucking shelf.
All right, well.
Yeah, that might be a pass for me.
Well, I think now that we got our full group on tonight, I think we should move on to our custom spotlight. So you want to tell us what we're looking at here, Mr. Bako Aspire?
Sure thing. What I chose for the custom spotlight this evening was an MP-scaled solar tower by Mr. Stephen Sidella. What makes, you know, he always does good work. I'm sorry, great work. I'm really baked right now. anyway, always does great work, and the thing that makes this special is that he built it as a contest prize. The contest was for the Hardcore Collectors Group. The rules of the contest were one entry for every $20 spent on new toys donated to sick or needy children. And you were supposed to make a video of yourself dropping off the donation or something, but a video had to be involved. And then I guess there was a drawing of some sort, or maybe it was because his total contribution was over $200 to a children's hospital. His name is Robert Wang. I'm saying Wang because the H is before the W, and I want to pronounce it correctly. He was the winner. And giving $200 to children's hospital was a great thing. So good on him. Good on Steve. I'm sorry, Steven. He likes to be called Steve.
So for those unaware of what we're talking about, this is the little toy thing that comes with MP Grapple, only it's fucking huge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And names were drawn from a hat by his son, Gavin. So I guess they did draw. Tower that is constructed like of PVC pipe, ring guard insulation foam with dowels, and construction grade tubing.
Yeah, it looks great. It's a really cool thing.
Yep. And it is properly in scale.
It's nice of them to do something besides banner cast. They still suck it.
Was this the episode that Red Alert was having that kind of like paranoia issues? And
No.
This was Grapple's spotlight episode.
Yeah, this was the master builder where Grapple wanted to build this thing, and then the Constructicons overheard him, and they're like, oh, well, we'll cooperate, and he's like, oh, I can't trust you, Decepticons, and they're like, well, we'd never betray you, and then they betray him.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
But yeah, Steven makes a lot of really cool stuff, though. Like, he's a really good dude.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, let's move on to our next item, and that is KO Korner.
Yay!
This is horrible.
I think that's the most real thing we've seen so far. Mm.
So tell us what we're looking at here, Chris.
Oh, you want me to help?
Yeah, I want you.
We are looking at an array of superhero knockoff toys. The first of which is Mexi Action DC Superheroes El Supermano.
Yeah.
The packaging is that of a Mexican flag. A blister pack with a green suited Superman character with a sombrero and a very stereotypically racist Mexican mustache. El Supermano.
Latino porn star Superman.
And the next one is just very, very simple. It's a yellow and orange gradient card with a blister pack on it. That's Superman. It looks kind of like Nicolas Cage, and it says Special Man.
Oh, they Special Man.
They made a figure out of JL.
Shut up.
I think my favorite of those fucking memes is the goddamn Loch Ness Monster.
You know, I think the one on the left kind of looks like Burt Reynolds a little bit.
Kinda. Gone too soon, Burt. Gone too soon.
Yeah, for real, man.
And next up is a multi-pack of a whole bunch of IP theft. We got Cars, Shrek, The Incredibles, Power Rangers, Batman, Turtles. I think that might be Venom.
All on the packaging?
Yeah, all on the packaging. But in the pack, we have a yellow Cars car. Our yellow and one shoulder and arm colored black for shits and giggles. Power Ranger. Looks like animated Superman. And
blue collar Superman. He's got the rolled up sleeves.
Yeah, he's coming to work. Batman. Spider-Man, who looks like he's seen better days.
Yeah.
And what can only be described best as a dog chew toy Shrek.
A very dark green.
Yeah. I would say he's the Wesley Snipes of Shreks.
It looks like Spider-Man and earning extra money as a stripper on the side. The fucking underwear he's wearing.
Man, this next one, I think we need to get it for catfish.
Yeah, you know what? I would buy this Sense of Right Alliance if I found it somewhere for like $5. I would buy it just to have it. I would hang it above my door so that the knockoff fairy knows it, you know, not to come here.
And there's color variations. You know, some get a blue car and blue ranger.
Can I get a blue Shrek, like a blue corpse Shrek?
Maybe.
Like a dead Shrek.
With donkey.
It looks less like Shrek and more like Yoda fucked Winnie the Pooh.
Mm. Yeah. I got that, yeah.
How about this next one?
I want this one, too.
Now, this next thing is actually something fucking legit.
Right, but that's toy bits.
Yeah, it's so fucking stupid that I had to put it in here. Spider-Man Adventure Hero is a line by Toy Biz that takes a Spider-Man figure and dresses him up like fucking Ken dolls. We have a two-pack of the Fisherman and the Archer with their accessories, and notably they are packaged crisscross from the picture that depicts what the fuck's in it. So, mm-hmm. Fisherman picture is in front of the fucking Archer.
Captain America Archer.
It's like a random CEO was at Toy Biz and decided because he's got, you know, these outdoor pastimes that let's just do Spider-Man because that's what I like.
He's got a fucking fishing pole with a huge goddamn dick on the fucking front of it. It ain't a spider.
I tell you what, that fishing pole is pretty well detailed, though. That's a pretty nice looking toy fishing pole.
Yeah, that's better than the one that came with MP Hot Rod.
But he got on fucking MC Hammer Pants fucking Raiders.
Yeah.
And a tackle box, so that's pretty cool.
I like the way his waders make it look like he just cut the crotch out of his pants.
Yeah, it does.
It's fucking peekaboo surprise Spider-Man.
It's so warm out here. I just need to cool off.
It's bachelorette party strip.
I bet you can't fish. I bet you can't fish and hunt at the same time. I bet I can.
So does it come with the little fish in the little picture there?
Probably. It's probably inside the tackle box.
And then there was a whole line of this shit. I only put a couple things in.
I got you know what? I need to collect this entire line.
We had Beach Spider-Man, so his arms are exposed, and I guess below his fucking knees exposed, and the rest is like just parts of the spider suit.
It's so dumb.
But the fucking shirt he's wearing looks like he's got a fucking beach ball on it.
It's almost like a knockoff Stretch Armstrong is what it looks like.
So you know what it is? It's a wave. Oh, my God. And he's got a beach ball, and he's got a fucking lifeguard fucking rigged thing.
Is that a baseball cap?
Oh, this is Spider-Man played by the Hoff, huh?
Yeah. It looks like a baseball cap, dude.
It could be.
Yeah.
Maybe you put it on backwards, and he's even cooler.
Yeah. He leads a gang in the middle of the city, turns it sideways.
And we're going to leave Bayside High here and fucking go to the soccer field.
Yeah. Who likes short shorts?
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I tell you what, he didn't skip leg day.
No, he did not.
No, he didn't.
God damn, look at those calves.
How come the legs are different? How come the back of the legs are a different color than the front?
Look at that leg.
And how come his shirt has a number 10 on the back of it, but a number 17 on the front?
Exactly.
If I ever play soccer, I want to do that. I want the shirt, the front half of the shirt to be my team or be the enemy's team, and the back half of the shirt to be my team.
Oh, that'd be like punch counter punch.
Yeah, I always just face the opposing team. They'll just let me run right in there.
All right. Well, last is the two pack of the ninja and space costumes.
Yeah, because those are related.
Look at those knee pads.
And this is why Toy Biz is the leading toy manufacturer in America right now. Oh, wait, never mind. They're gone.
Who the fuck pitched this and thought this was a great idea?
I just realized that the flesh-colored legs are the same mold as the spider suit legs. That's why it looks so fucking weird. Because it looks horrible in blue, but it looks really dumb in flesh-colored.
Mm-hmm. And for some reason, way too much more detailed.
Yeah, I'm going to get the soccer one and just have a little dick that hangs out of the pants leg. And I'm going to put it up on the mantle for people to see when they come back. Yeah.
With just a head popping out below the fucking shorts.
What's that? Oh, that's just me wearing a Spider-Man mask playing soccer.
And the freaking ninja suit looks like Spider-Man cosplaying as like a really bad Scorpion from Mortal Kombat.
Look at the calves. Look at the calves on the legs, dude. That's not natural.
Is that a mask that he's going to put over his mask?
Yes. He really can't.
Brilliant.
To go with the clothes to put over his fucking superhero uniform.
Gosh. Wow, that is terrible.
Yeah, it is pretty damn bad. Ever. But I still strangely want it. But I bet it's expensive as shit. Did you see how much any of these things cost while you were looking at them?
Oh, God, no.
That's fine. I think we need to find out. This is information our people need.
All right, that's your homework.
You know, JL.
The point is, when I missed sometime like 2005. Somewhere around there?
Could be. It looked old. Well, not old, old. Jesus. I'm fucking referring to 2005 is old.
Well, Spider-Man Outdoor Heroes doesn't show you anything on eBay, so it might be something super rare.
Don't look up Outdoor Heroes. It's under Adventure Hero line.
Maybe it was marketed for, like, Gander Mountains and Dick's Sporting Goods or something.
Oh, no, man.
Man,
you missed the best one, dude. There's a Spider-Man Adventure Hero Extreme Sports Skateboard and Scooter figure.
I didn't see packaging for that one, so I didn't think.
I have it right here, man. You want to see it?
Go ahead, put it in.
Put it in the chat. You got to click the link. You got to see the back of the thing, too. Oh, my God, dude.
Jesus Christ. Right.
Spider-Man's wearing a safety helmet. It's only $34. Who wants to go in half on this set?
Oh my god, this is so fucking gay.
Oh my god, this is the best one, and you didn't even have it.
He kind of looks like Marty McFly.
There's a baseball one, too. The baseball one's $34. The soccer one's like $199. Oh. There's a bunch of these. There's a skydiving parachuting Spider-Man. There's a firefighter Spider-Man. There's a firefighter Spider-Man, dude.
I did see that one, but I wasn't going to put that one.
These are great. There's a bunch of those, man. Fist of Fury. There's a karate kickboxing Spider-Man. Mm. There's way too many of these.
I wonder how they sold.
They sold a lot of them. There's a bunch of them on eBay.
No, yeah, these are ones
that sold a lot of them.
These are ones people found at thrift stores for a dollar. Trying to flip them.
Yeah. Here I am. All I want is that Captain Kirk, but I've been wrong. I want this.
So speaking of only paying a dollar, maybe we should move on to our next segment.
Yeah.
And we're temporarily changing the name since we had a shift in responsibilities here on the show. So Bedbug's Bargain Bin is now
JL's Sav’a-Lot Corner. Because that's the name of a grocery store I never go to.
So tell us what we have for our savings.
You mean to tell me you've never had the pleasure of opening a box? A bag of Jay Riggins potato chips?
No. But I do have the pleasure of having what are probably knockoffs of the Impossible Toys, Kranix, and Arbalest figures. And they come with an Alphatron. And y'all might remember this episode because we made a point not to let you know where we found them in case there was only a few left. So after me and Chris bought a few of them, a few couple sets of them, and 6 months later, they're still online. So I'm guessing they're knockoffs. or somebody was clearing out the dumpster at the Impossible Toys warehouse when they sold it at auction and found all these figures. But these are the incredibly rare Arbalest and Cranix figures that Impossible Toys made near the end of their lifespan. And I'll tell you what, they feel like they're made out of Lucky Charms marshmallows.
they're not horrible. Bad. No, they're horrible, dudes.
Yeah, but they stand there and they look like Cranix in Arbalest. Yeah. And for some reason, it came with the Alpha Trion that I don't remember them ever making. And this can be yours for $29.99 shipped from China.
Yep.
And they sold 72 of them, and there's more than 10 available. So you better stock up because this is going to be the hottest item next Christmas.
Yep.
So you guys got these?
Oh, yeah. Oh, dude, I got what's probably now a $1,000 Quintesson shelf. It was the first shelf I ever did in a Detolf, too, man. It's all the Quints, and it's got the Charticon exclusives. Like, I love it.
I got one of the Quintessons from Impossible Toys, but I don't remember these. Are they kind of in scale? Because they look kind of small.
They're scaled with the rest of the Quint figures.
Hey, I got $35 for that.
Yeah, $35 for what?
The Quint.
For like the Quint 01?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good deal. You should sell it to him. No, I'm joking. Mm-hmm. Which Quintesson do you have?
The old one.
You have the original one?
Yeah.
Well, that's at least a solid $40, Chris.
Oh, all right. I'll get 40.
He's laughing at your ass, too.
Shift. 40 ship, right?
Yeah.
Wow. I don't know.
Yeah, man, I'm not fucking...
We're fucking with you, man.
Yep.
That thing's
he's like, yep. He didn't want to say no on the air.
Fucking dollars, and I'm still not buying it.
But if you wanted these ever, these are either... the really shitty production run of them or a really shitty knockoff. Either way, it's the same thing. And you should buy them for $30 from China. And I did find something else today. I don't want to say, well, I guess you'll be able to figure it out. But I finally found something.
I don't want my deals to be ruined.
Yeah. But BBTS has the G2... which one is that? Slag?
Mm-hmm.
It has a G2 slag for the G2 Scoria for $144 on sale. And these things were all really hard to find, and I had no idea that the whole time BBTS had him and the G2 Sever in stock. So I finally cashed in that $100 gift card I got for buying the RoboCop Hot Toys set. And picked up the G2, the Sever, which is the red one. And I got him for like $83 after I cashed in the coupon. And yes. I have finally finished the G2 Dinobots.
Yay.
I love those, man. I love those crazy colors on those figures, man. But yeah, if you don't have the G2 slag, you should pick them up. It's a good deal.
If they ever did make a swoop, what color do you think they would have made it?
I want purple. If they did one, I think purple would be good. I think that there's actually art out there from concept art for him and
what the yellow with tiger stripes or something like that?
Sludge. Yeah, I think it was some crazy looking shit. So you know what? I'll look it up and I will bring pictures of it next week. And that is JL Sav’a’Lot. And I wish I had a better name than that, but that's going to have to do because I made it up in 50 seconds.
All right. Our next item is Asshole of the Week.
Yay. And we got a doozy this week.
And this one has got A lot of people salty. And
oh, hang on, my blood pressure is going up.
So, Maketoys.
Yay!
Apparently, when they first revealed their Seeker mold at TFCon, it had some additional parts, and then they released the figure without the parts, and now they are selling the parts.
Or a bad, we sorry.
So
you could buy it for $29.95.
I'm unfamiliar with this mold, so what parts exactly in the picture are there that are not on your figure, JL?
The entire back of the wing.
Oh.
That's a waffle on the figure you paid $130 for that came out over a year ago.
Oh.
Or just about a year ago, because it came out at TFCon. Mm-hmm. And they were in the prototype pictures, and then all of a sudden they started disappearing from the, you know, from the pre-release pictures.
Hmm.
Then a year later, now they have returned as an accessory.
Mm-hmm.
So do you feel this is a teaser that they're going to do a reissue of Howling Meteor with the parts?
No, they're just going to sell these parts for $15 a set. They should include them with the cone heads, I feel like. Like when you buy the first cone head, you get Starscream's wingbacks. But well, you know what they're going to do? They're going to release the clone heads without them too. And then a year later, we're going to be buying their wingbacks. But I remember their prototype pictures had this, and then they disappeared. And I was assuming the whole time that, you know, that they were forgetting to put them on, you know, with the pre-release picks. And then when it finally came out, it was indeed missing those parts, and now they're available for sale separately. And I think that's kind of a dirtbag move.
So
I'd be pissed.
But
so are you going to still continue to buy Make Toy Seekers?
I only have the first one so far. I haven't bought the other ones yet. I'm going to buy the cone heads. And I was about to give a big butt because I still do like Make Toys. Like, they made that G2 Jazz, and I love that motherfucker.
Let's talk about your big butt, Simone.
What?
So what's your opinion about this, Chris? How do you feel about Make Toys doing this?
It is bullshit because it was on the prototype. But, I mean, as you go along, they release product shots. And if the product shots that were coming up didn't have the fillers and nobody caught on to it, it's kind of partly us to blame because we didn't fucking say something about it. Because everybody sees this shit as it's coming live. You know, it's been going on for a year with this thing.
Right.
So, before that, how long was it from the time they announced it that they were doing them till the fucking prototype came out, till it was out in sale? It was about a year?
It was a while.
So, all these motherfuckers, us included, who are online, nobody caught it. All these sets of eyes didn't catch that those fucking things were gone and called them on it. Because we do have ways of communicating to these companies our displeasure.
I keep sending them dick pics, but I still don't get anything for free.
So do you think this dick move, because the Skywarp and Thundercracker are both unreleased, right?
Mm-hmm.
So do you think this might affect their orders going forward? That people are like, well, fuck you, I'm not going to buy any more of your product because of what you're doing.
No, everybody's going to bitch and still give them their money.
Exactly. That's what we do. We want the right to bitch. That's all.
Mm-hmm.
So just fucking give me the whole fucking set, all three fucking Seekers that are available for fucking $30 for this fucking filler set, and I'll buy it.
So that's all that's missing is the underside of the wings?
Yep. But you don't display your figures from the back!
Hmm.
Oh.
To leave a part off like that, it really does make it seem like the toy was shipped out incomplete.
It's like maybe somebody stole the... Maybe they hadn't quite finished molding it yet, and somebody stole them off that first prototype, and they couldn't make any more copies. That was the ones they were going to send off to have the actual molds made for the thing.
Hey, look, guys. you know, we got all this awesome engineering that we did in-house and everything, figured out how to make this fucking thing transform from a jet to a fucking robot and back and forth again. But you know what we can't do? We can't reproduce those fucking flat filler pieces.
I've been tempted to get Howling Meteor to replace my Hasbro one, because I still have the original Hasbro one with the hip kibble. And I guess now I'm going to wait and see what they do, if they actually do a second release that has the parts with it.
And, well, I do love that figure, and I would like to replace the other two Seekers. It hasn't become that important to me yet.
So you have this Starscream, but you still have the original Hasbro Seekers, the Thundercracker and Skywarp?
Yeah, because they're in the back. Like, they're behind, you know, Shockwave and Reflector and all that shit. They're not in the front. If they were in the front, I might be more keen. Especially Skywarp, because yeah. I have the MP3 Skywarp.
Yeah, that one needs to be replaced. And
I got Starscream and Skywarp. I left Thundercracker as the fucking, I think it's even the Walmart. No, it's not the Walmart.
The Toys R Us one.
No, I got rid of that when I got the fucking actual KO Yes model or whatever.
You know, proper blue one. I do like the darker blue one that came from Toys R Us. I still like that color and that figure.
But it's not right.
If I look at everything on this shelf, there's a lot of stuff in there that's not 100% right.
Well, with Maketoys, they did Thundercracker with light blue, right?
Say what? Right.
Did Maketoys use a lighter blue for their Thundercracker?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
I think so, did, yeah.
So the original Hasbro one could be the Seeker that goes, the Rainmaker that goes with Sunstorm, right? Because there was a blue one that went there, too.
He's not really... It's a really weird bluish purple, like a periwinkle, if you want to be 100% accurate.
Well, I would be perfectly... If I go this route and start replacing Seekers, I'm in the same boat as JL, except I still have the original Starscream. I would get all three of the Seekers that Maketoys is doing, and then I would move my Hasbro Thundercracker back with my Storm, since they all share the same mold anyway, and those would be my Rainmakers. But we'll see. I have higher priorities before I start replacing Seekers.
Is it weird that every time I hear the word Rainmaker, I fucking think of somebody fucking making it rain on the stripper with cash?
Well, that might happen at TFCon, you never know.
Maybe
JC is gonna be so fucking high.
Gonna get bugs and pussy.
All right, let's move on then to our 13 questions with Phil Hamilton. How's it going, sir?
Oh, now I'm nervous.
Oh, you're nervous.
Yep, divulge anything you need to know of me.
Oh, well, we're about to get to know all of you.
How wide in length and in circumference can you accept anally?
All right, I was thinking about sharing this with you know, all my friends on Facebook. I think we're past that now. It's just for me now.
All right, so what is your preferred name or handle when on the interwebs?
I've had the name and handle RavensCloud9 for about 20 years. I don't remember why I went with that, but that's what I've been using for my gamer handle on, like, PlayStation and Nintendo stuff. So.
And Pokemon.
Oh, yeah, that too.
Pokemon!
All right, so what year were you born, sir?
The bicentennial year of 1976.
Oh, 70s, baby, yay!
Chris gets so excited.
All right. I know I'm not alone in my age.
Yeah. So what's your favorite sandwich?
Any sandwich, really. But what I like to do, I make myself. Like, I'll get, like, a long French bread, and I'll just stuff that with deli meats, any kind. And, you know, I'll throw that provolone cheese and onions, pickles, tomatoes, lettuce. And, you know, I watched I think like it was a Good Eats on the Food Network with Alton Brown, and he showed like how to make a really good long French bread sandwich, and you gotta like let that sit in Saran wrap overnight, and like all the flavors get mixed in, and I tried that. It is, I know sandwiches are instant gratification, but yeah, you gotta try that sometime.
And that was the one he hollowed out the baguette, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Hmm. Does sound tasty. All right, so what is your favorite music?
Not country.
Country road, taking me home.
Oh. So, I work in Sparta, Wisconsin, and I work at a archery manufacturer. And there's a lot of guys that love country there, and they play it all day, every day.
Dude, do you know fucking
it's Ted misery. Nugent? Just misery. What?
Do you know Ted Nugent?
Yeah, I met him twice.
Oh, you poor bastard.
He's not fun.
So have you filed a workman's comp claim on your ears yet?
I could. I definitely could. There's no way to get around it because they play it over the loudspeaker sometimes, and my only reprieve is Christmas when they start playing Christmas music. So,
so it's kind of a vacation for your ears.
But is it Christmas? Yeah. Is it country Christmas?
Oh, they'll mix that in. It's Wisconsin.
Yeah, they'll mix it all up. Mm. They'll play the Carrie Underwood Grinch song or like a dozen times. So, gah.
All right. So, what got you into collecting or back into collecting?
So, I really wasn't collecting toys for a better part of my younger adult life. It wasn't until like my second daughter was born that I felt the need to want to collect. When I first got my Transformer, like in 2005, it was at the beginning of the Cybertron line. And because I saw like the huge Starscream that they had, the Titan class one. Mm-hmm. And you know, they had the Optimus Prime in later class, and those looked like G1 characters, you know, finally. So that's what kind of got my interest back into it. It was right there that I remembered what Transformers were. I didn't have a whole bunch of them when I was a kid,
right?
But I remember the cartoon and being, you know, kind of nostalgic, and that's the first time the nostalgia bug hit me. So. Yeah, I do it for just the cartoon, really. Just to remember that as a kid, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, that psychological break happened when the kid was born. You're like, all right, it's all over. I gotta fucking find something from my childhood. I'm gonna have something.
Give me a lifeline. Just a little bit. I don't want
to. I went through the same fucking thing. I think it definitely happened after the birth of my second one. Not, I don't think it was like a correlation kind of thing, but not too soon after.
Well, I know the correlation, but I didn't want to, you know, go down a sad road. But I'll explain the story. I grew up, you know, in the country in Sparta, and it was nothing but, you know, hills, woods, farms, and. There happened to be a next-door neighbor that lived on a farm that was my age also. And we were best friends for a very long time. Up to the point of when Transformers came out, we kind of, like, distanced ourselves for some reason. I really don't know. But, you know, we kind of hung out every once in a while, but in 2005... I was shocked to hear the news that he killed himself. And when I heard that, you know, I was like, I really wish I really got to connect with him again. And, you know, then maybe things would have changed. But since then, it was like, you felt like that piece of childhood was kind of gone. And it isn't like a desperate attempt to hold on to it, but it's something that you want to not forget about.
It's a touchstone.
Yeah.
Something that you can,
so
you hold these figures in your hand and it reminds you of something that you share with you.
Exactly. And I've made tons of friends since then through this. So yeah, it's definitely a good part of my life that I enjoy the most. So
that's not a sad story, that's a life story.
Yeah.
I can relate to that. I mean, I don't know if you remember him. He went to a couple dairy cons, but a friend of mine, Colin Perrin from Madison, he had kind of a stutter or a twitch, and I had moved back home, and I hadn't heard anything from him on Facebook for a while, and here I found out he had actually killed himself, and I felt so horrible, because when I was in Madison, I was actually a security guard at TDS Telecom on the Beltway, and he worked there, so like I got to see him at night, and we'd talk Transformers when I'd be coming in, and he'd be going home. And it's hard when you know somebody and then they do that and then you have to move on, and it sucks. I hated it. But not to be a complete downer, let's move on to our next question. Right. What scale do you collect, sir?
I collect a kind of like a larger scale. So around Masterpiece, I like a lot of Voyager-sized ones, but I still have a bunch of Deluxes. I did get into the smaller Legend ones from around the Cybertron line and, you know, onward, but I like them all, really. I don't have a huge collection like I used to. I have mostly a character-based collection. I mean, like, one of each. I don't have, like, multiple Primes. I don't have multiple Megatrons or Starscreams. It's pretty much just focused on each of the cast, really.
Mm-hmm. Now, where does your cutoff? Like, I mean, you know, at what season do you say, okay, you know what, I don't really need the fucking predicate. Predacons or C-cons or, you know, shit like that.
Those are great and everything, and I don't really have to focus on the cartoon as long as it looks good and still has, like, you know, Decepticon logos. So I guess I don't really get into the Japanese era, like after G1, mm-hmm. and I don't really do any Beast Wars. But If it's focused on G1, that's really it.
Okay. So, do you have any non-TF collections? Because you already said that you only buy one of each character, so you don't have a focus collection. But do you collect anything outside of Transformers?
Yeah. I have a collector's mentality. I have the 3¼ or 3¾. Marvel Universe line. Okay. I pretty much got all of that.
Nice.
That has also been a big part of my collecting. They've stopped the line pretty much, but I have that. Let's see. I have an autograph collection from former wrestlers.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of your pictures that you've taken with wrestlers.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Bret Hart, Jeff Jarrett, Kevin Nash. A lot of the guys from back in the day. Really like that.
You got an Iron Sheik?
I wish. He doesn't come out much. He's got his podcast, though.
He's very open.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know he'd be a hard one to kind of get to know in public. He's gotten salty.
Yeah, a little bit. But anything else?
No, that's it. That's all I'm going to divulge right now.
All right. To KO or to not KO?
Yeah, I'd buy KO.
No. Damn right.
If I mean, as a consumer, you have to look out for yourself. If it's just as good quality, you know, and you're willing to risk, you know, not being the actual thing, go for it. I mean,
amen, brother. Preach it to the people.
Okay. That's, yeah, that's it.
Well, as long as you don't care about your peener size, I guess it's okay.
Wow.
All right, so what movie makes you cry?
I really don't remember the last movie that made me cry. I tell you what does, though. YouTube videos where soldiers are coming home, you know, to their kids or their wives or, you know, a family member that really missed them a lot.
Like the surprise, surprise ones?
Yeah, do you especially like the surprise ones?
Oh, yeah. I don't know what it is. It's that moment of joy, like, in disbelief and, you know, like a wish came true. I don't know if it's because they add the sappy music to it or what, but seeing a person's, you know, overall, like, overwhelming emotion, I connect with that. So, yeah, that's what gets me. And there's nothing gay about that either.
Did you serve?
But it can be.
All right. Have you ever done anything untoward for your toy addiction?
I want to say yes.
Uh-oh.
So, I got a call from my daughter. She was at, this is a couple of years back. She was at middle school, and she fell backwards on a bleacher. And fell backwards and hit the back of her head. And the school said that she thinks she might have a concussion. So I explained that to my boss, and I went and got her and brought her home. In actuality, that was the story I told them, so I could run to Toys R Us and get that MP Grimlock.
Yeah!
Damn, dude.
That is untoward.
I don't know if that's untoward, but
that's pretty untoward. That's pretty bad.
I call, you know, Toys R Us like almost every day for like 2 weeks just to make sure that shipment came in. They only had 6 of them, so yeah, I was going at noon right then and there to get it.
So, did she have a concussion?
No, that was the story I told them.
I didn't know, God.
Did you snatch one out of a little kid's hands?
Well, there was only 4 when I got there.
That's a story you'll never be able to tell again, since Toys R Us is gone.
Yep, this show is for me now. That's it.
And was this a former employer?
No, currently.
Oh, shit.
Okay, they don't mind.
Blackmail.
Hey, can you guys actually hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, my headset kicked off earlier, and I think it muted me for a while.
Yeah, it did. You were quiet.
Cringer.
I was yelling fucking swear words at you the whole time.
That's all right, Phil. My boss doesn't know I'm not coming in tomorrow either.
What?
I got a call from the full-time postal carrier. He wanted tomorrow off because he bought a new four-wheeler, and he wanted to go play with it up north at his cabin. So... tomorrow morning, I'll call my full-time job and let them know I won't be coming in because the full-timer at the post office is sick.
Did he tell the postmaster that his daughter got a concussion?
No.
It works. It works.
But I'm going to lie and pretend I had no idea I was going to have to cover mail route tomorrow when I call the full-time boss in the morning. So, Anyway, let's move on to our next question. When it comes to women, is it tits, ass, legs, face, or other for you, sir?
All of it. I love women. I can't help it. They're beautiful, mysterious, everything. Yep.
You don't have a personal favorite, though, huh?
Tits.
Yay!
they stare at me, and I can't help but stare back.
They see right to your soul.
Good man. Yep. All right, so what's a weird thing about you, such as an idiosyncrasy or a phobia? Hidden talent?
Nothing really. God, I'm pretty boring.
Can you tie a knot in a cherry stem with your tongue?
You know, I probably had thought of something earlier, but... I got nothing. Nothing, you know, all the normal things scare me. Spider snakes, afraid of heights.
Well, that's something. It doesn't have to be a super weird fear if you're scared of something, you know. I'm not a big fan of heights either, but I've gone to the top of the Statue of Liberty and the Empire State Building and looked down.
Yeah, I'm just going to go with heights. I've been to the St. Louis Arch 4 times in my life, and I've never gone up it.
Wow.
Just yeah, freak out at the last second.
How do you go up it? You have to...
There's an elevator that moves up at an angle.
Really?
Yeah, it's like a sideways elevator.
Oh, that's cool as shit.
It's a Wonkavator.
Wonkavator.
It is.
Keep your hands to yourself, Chris.
Oops. I'm sorry.
This elevator is not the only crooked thing in here.
Maybe you can help me straighten out my Longfellow.
Gross.
Speaking of, question
Longfellow.
What is your go-to sex position?
It's, I guess, my go-to, like what I like the most, doggy.
Yeah.
But what ends up usually happening is just straight up, you know, missionary. So, what I want to try is, well, what I really want to, you know, do more of is more of what I like to call the Triforce.
Ooh, do tell.
So, it's kind of like missionary. I'm more of a, you know, at an incline, you know, rather than just laying right on top. She's got, you know, her ass up in the air, knees practically touching her shoulders. I've got my arms holding down, you know, her arms, and, you know, it's just gravity force.
Hmm.
And, yeah.
Also known as rake thrust.
JL, you still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
Is there crying involved?
There's lots of noises.
All right. Well, that was our 13 questions. Phill managed to make it through all of them.
I shouldn't be sweating, should I?
I shouldn't be sweating either.
I don't know, you might want to get that resume together.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's move on to our TKO Girls of the Week. So who do we got here first?
Of course, it's mine. Look at her. Fucking hot redhead. The goddamn tan line little heart tattoos.
You know, yeah,
that's kind of stupid.
Sunblock on, just on that one little pattern.
I don't care how hot you are. If you fall asleep near me, you're getting a suntan fucking dick tattoo.
but she's wearing a little tiny fucking pair of cut-off jean shorts that are unzipped pretty much all the way.
And here I thought we were done with Police Academy references.
What?
You don't remember when they put the sunscreen on
Do you think those pants actually fit her, or somehow she found a pair that are too small for even her?
I don't think so, man. She is pretty small.
I don't think she can zip those up, man.
It's just something about her face and her overall shape was just appealing to me.
I love it.
Okay. Well, the next one I picked. So she actually looks really young.
And... She actually has a smaller pair of pants. Yes, I didn't know they could get any smaller, but they did.
But I was waiting for JC to come on the show and be an old creepy perv, but whatever. But we're looking at a blonde who's very tan and wearing a bikini and very short shorts over it. The bikini's orange, and she's got a look like, yeah.
It looks like she unfolded a fucking Pop-Tart wrapper and wrapped it around her waist.
Yeah.
It's about the same size.
What do you mean I'm not supposed to wear a tinfoil off her hands?
Yeah. And somehow they're tattered, like they've actually been worn out.
Yeah,
it's like strings hanging underneath them, Sam. Either that or that's your tampon string hanging out.
That's what ruined it.
Maybe that's what it is, dude. Look at it. See it? She got like 8 of them bad boys up in there.
Probably needs that many.
Gross.
Maybe she's warming Hot Pockets.
Maybe she's smuggling drugs into the country. Hey, that's where all your punch counter punches went. She had to smuggle them in from Malaysia.
No wonder the shoulders are bad.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, because that's why they're packed the way they are in the box. The shoulders up in the air straight. Oh, man.
Let's move on to our last one.
Now, this is a beautiful set of tanned legs right here. nice and orange and tanned.
Gross.
I just want to crack them open and suck the meat out. Because these are crab legs. These are particularly snow crab legs that are not native to North Carolina. But I still eat them anyways because they're very delicious.
I didn't know Long John Silver's had that.
They don't have that. My anniversary was yesterday.
Me and
my wife have been married for 14 years. We're celebrating 3 happy years together.
Congrats.
No, I'm joking. It's actually been a pretty solid 14 years. It's been really good, actually. But there's this place called Captain George's. They're a somewhat famous, very large buffet that has seafood and everything, steak, dessert, anything you could want on it. It's also very expensive, and I don't go very often because I'm not a really huge carnivore, but I do like some crab legs. So she likes to go there. I took her there, and we just gorged ourselves until I got sick and passed out.
I love crab legs. They taste great.
Yeah, me too. Those were good, man. They had some good shrimp, too. And they have butter, margarine, and then they have this thing called the Captain's Blend, which tastes kind of like butter with, like, Cajun seasoning in it. It's really good. It has a vinegar tang to it after you're done eating it, though. It's, like, really good.
That's the Captain's.
Yeah, I hope so.
My only issue with crab legs is that it's a whole lot of... It's good reward, but a whole lot of effort.
Yeah, but, you know, if you're going to spend that much money, you might as well sit there for 2 hours eating food.
Mm-hmm.
And that was just the first plate, and I went through about 3 of those.
Mm. Yeah.
I mean, the truth is, it's not a lot of food on that plate, really. Once you take it all out, you've got like half a hamburger's bun worth of meat. That shit was good. And she bought me for my anniversary, the entire Jurassic Park series, including the new movies on 4K in a box set. That's pretty cool.
Yay.
And moving on.
All right. Well, let's move on to our listener questions. Andrew Gort asks, what is your favorite type of pie, and do you eat the whole thing or share?
Poontang.
So do you share?
Depends. What's my blood alcohol content level? No, I'm kidding. She would fucking kill me if I said that. Luckily for me, she and most of America doesn't listen. My favorite pie is probably key lime pie. I love key lime pie.
So could you sit there and eat the whole thing?
Probably. I'm going to stick with that.
How about you, Chris?
I'm not a pie guy.
Find a meat pie.
No. There's a thing that my mom's godmother made. It's basically a ricotta cheese pie. It's an Italian custardy kind of thing, similar to a cheesecake, but not at all as tangy.
I love custard, man.
It's got a more creamy consistency. But that shit's delicious. It's got a graham cracker crust.
You need to make me that shit. Send it to me.
I don't have the recipe.
Mm-hmm.
But it's been years since I had that shit. It's delicious. I miss it. And I would eat the whole fucking thing. And if I didn't eat it in one sitting, I would fucking wrap it up. And also, it has cinnamon on top.
How about you, Phil? What kind of pie do you like?
I like all pies. The citrus ones, like key lime and lemon meringue, I'm not a big fan of. But anything else, I will eat. No problem. But I really, if I had to pick one, it'd probably be cherry pie. I don't think I could eat a whole pie by myself. And if I was able to, I'd probably have to make it myself. But I'm not really much of a baker. You know, I don't think I could probably do that. Yeah, cherry. Love cherry.
My personal favorite is strawberry rhubarb.
The fuck is a rhubarb?
You've never had rhubarb before, JL?
It sounds like something you shouldn't eat. It sounds like a vegetable.
It's a root vegetable.
Nope.
No, it's got a tart flavor to it.
Hang on a second.
dude, if you've like eaten like anything sour, like Warheads or Sweet Tarts or something like that, that's artificial rhubarb is the way you look at it. And when you put that shit with strawberry inside a pie, it is heaven, especially if you throw a little whipped cream on top of it. Oh, so fucking good.
Well, I wanted to add that as far as key lime pie goes, I prefer the less tart ones, the less sour ones.
So is it like fruit steroids?
You asking me or JL?
You.
He's asking you.
If you add it to another fruit, it just amplifies that fruit flavor?
It's just the combination of the sweetness and the tartness. It makes it really, really good. Mm. So it's like a sweet and sour mix. And the one thing, JL, with rhubarb, if you ever handle it, the leaves are actually kind of poisonous on top. So, like, it grows kind of like celery, so you gotta, like, cut the tops off and only eat the stalks in the middle.
Can you get high on it if you chew on it?
That I don't know.
Can I add something to this question since we kind of got through this stuff kind of quick?
Sure.
I think we should go even further. What's your favorite dessert? Like, period.
I would stick with the same thing.
Not a pie. Although mine resembles a pie.
Yeah, I don't have much excuse, but I want to say, like,
either, normally.
My wife makes this, like, really light, fluffy, flaky type crust, and she serves it with custard and whipped cream and chocolate drizzle on top. It's like an eclair type thing. So good.
That sounds baller as fuck.
My mom makes those. Cream puffs. That's what she calls them.
I need one of those.
They got like a vanilla pudding kind of in them.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
And then just to fucking make it that much worse for you, powdered sugar sprinkled on top.
Yay.
Mm.
What about you, bed bugs?
If I had to pick a favorite dessert, honestly, I love myself a really good banana split. That's what I really like. I haven't had one in a while, but if I could have one right now, it'd be awesome.
Are you saying you want a banana right now?
Yeah, he does.
You got to say the toppings. What would you throw on it?
Wet nuts.
Oh, gosh. Well, you
he's right, though. I'm going to laugh at it, but he's right. That's the wet walnuts, right?
The crushed nuts on top with vanilla ice cream. I'm not too picky on syrup, but I'm fine with strawberry, chocolate, or both. You got to have the whipped cream. I'm not too big on raw cherries, so I don't typically put cherry on top, but I like it with crushed pineapple and crushed strawberry under. And I think that, other than the banana, I think that'd be about it.
I don't really like bananas that much.
Yeah, I don't like it at all.
Yeah, bananas are kind of gross. I mean, I'll eat them because they're the most convenient fruit to carry around.
Mm.
Bananas and watermelon are like the two fruits that I despise the most.
I love watermelon, though. I love it.
That those two flavors are just gross to me.
Yeah, I don't want to mix them together. That'd be really gross.
No, not together, but separately. Oh, together, they'd be horrible.
Mm-hmm. God, I'm going to make that for like TFCon and bring it. Fucking watermelon and banana pie with rhubarbs in it to make it even more intense. Maybe some mint leaves in it.
No, just make a smoothie.
Gross.
Oh.
Well, my favorite dessert is peach cobbler, which is really just peach pie, but peach cobbler, like fucking hot as shit with some ice cream thrown on it, some vanilla ice cream.
Yeah, a la mode. Really good.
Yeah.
Peach cobbler is if a peach pie had diarrhea.
Well, you know what? It's better. This is like those coffee beans they fish out of the bat's ass.
Yeah.
That's it.
I think like me a good rice pudding too.
Yeah, me too.
Now my friend of mine, he we were out one time and he got a thing of rice pudding and I think a French vanilla ice cream. Let the ice cream get a little melty and then mixed them together, like took spoonfuls of each. And he allowed me to try and I was like, this is pretty goddamn good. So if you're ever looking for a new taste sensation, go that route.
So since JC isn't here, I'm going to ask my question that I seen show up anyway. So there's a individual, if you know of Sean Long, and he went through a little bit of redneck family drama, and he had a girlfriend or fiance at one point, and she left him. And not only did she leave him, she left him for his brother. And now she is pregnant, and he was invited to the baby shower, and he was asking his fans, should he go?
No.
So my question to you all is, if your ex-girlfriend or fiance hooked up with your brother and was popping out a kid, would you go to the baby shower?
Fuck no.
Fuck no. God damn it, no.
No way. Nope.
New.
I'd leave that family as far behind me as I could.
Yeah, they deserve to die, and I hope they burn in hell.
Yeah, you might go and fucking lock the doors to the place they're at and fucking set it on fire.
Yeah, you're damn right.
Yeah.
Fuck, that's psyche destroying shit, man.
I concur. I agree that I would definitely distance myself from my brother and probably a good chunk of the rest of the family.
Dude, that would save me so much money because I wouldn't talk to the rest of my fucking family ever again. I'd be done. I would be done. Do they have any kids together?
No, Sean does not have any kids.
Well, at least there's that.
How long were they together?
I have no idea. I just seen the post and I'm like, damn, this belongs on Mari Povich.
Yeah, I mean, if they were only together long enough for him to bring her home and meet his brother. No, it's his ex-wife, though, right?
No, it's ex-girlfriend or ex-fiance.
I don't know. All right, this is starting to get weaker and weaker.
Sean wasn't married.
Is it going to be like they went on one date, he brought her home and met his brother, and they hit it off way better, and he stole her from him?
She swiped in the correct direction for me on fucking Tinder.
So I can't believe it. When she picked me up from the joint, my brother was with her.
Still, that's not something I'd want to deal with. I would be annoyed and grossed out.
Yeah, I would want everybody to die.
All right. Does anyone else have any discussion questions they want to present to the table?
No.
Why's my PP this color?
Does it look like
Stop dipping in the Kool-Aid, boy.
Does it look like the mushroom guy from Mario Kart?
Yeah, it does.
Did you see that one meme that fucking has Pence fucking licking the fucking ice cream? Yeah.
That was hilarious, dude.
Oh, man. Well, I think with that said, then, we're going to wrap up the show for the week. It was definitely a fun time. I want to thank our guest, Phill Hamilton, for coming on.
Thanks for having me on, guys.
Yeah, thanks for coming on, dude. Thanks for putting up with us for an hour.
Thanks for finally getting on.
But mostly, thanks for finally getting off.
Oh, yeah. That'll happen.
Gross.
And with that said, I just want to say, fuck Iowa and fuck Catfish. The Badgers are going to win this weekend.
Oh, that's right. This is the big weekend, isn't it?
Yes, nice. It is.
Oh, the fucking Redder. I'm just going to turn the fucking channel off all day.
Yep, Saturday night, there's going to be an ass whooping in Iowa City.
That's probably the only way you'll be able to get him back on is if they win.
Is this that time of year when y'all pick y'all's gladiators for the great fucking Northern War y'all have or whatever?
Oh, yeah.
Are you talking about the foosball?
Damn right.
Foosball, Bobby.
So,
it's the devil.
Yeah, it is. Well,
make sure to watch our page sometime this week. There should be a mega hat burning in a fire.
Sometimes we put stuff on it.
and if there isn't, then be ready to see a grown Wisconsinite be crying. Because there should be no reason why we lose this game. So, but that's it. We'll see y'all next week.
Goodbye, cruel world.
try to live without us for a whole week.
Good luck. We're out.
Since some people are too lazy to read, here are the shoutouts. Shout out to TF and WTF Ever, the greatest Transformers and what the fuck ever Facebook group ever. El No Customs, an international consortium of Transformers customizers and creators. Third Party TF Crashers, Yula Blamo. Hail Hasbro Reviews with Matthew Deluxe Baldwin. Shattercast Uncut. Bobby Skullface Reviews. Legions for the Fountain of Material. The Realm of Collectors. Figabangin. The entire Cool Table Network. The Blackout and Shout Podcast. And of course, girls who make bad decisions with their bodies and the fathers and or uncles that made them that way. And we wouldn't be a show without alcohol, marijuana, and coffee. The lifeblood of this program. If you liked what you heard and want more, like and subscribe. Comment and let us know what you thought. If you're on Facebook and want to join the party and become a fellow drag, we're at TF and WTF Ever. All hate mail can be sent to tkothepodcast@gmail.com. We'll be back next week with some more nonsense.